sure you open the Lambos out on Collins. I'll be. Hello friends, welcome to Everything You Need. In this channel, we have been uploading many videos on EMFA, that is electromagnetic fields and its applications, digital signal processing. And in the series of DNP, that is data network protocols, this is a video on flow controls, that is flow control by Everything You Need. Flow control is nothing but the data transmission in a network between the sender and a receiver. These flow control protocols are divided as noiseless and noise. In the noiseless, it is simplest and stop and wait protocols. In the noisy channel, it is stop and wait ARQ. ARQ stands for automatic repeat request and sliding window protocol. And sliding window protocol is further divided or classified as go back and ARQ and select queue ARQ. Let us see each of them in detail. First, simplest protocol. This is a unidirectional protocol in which data frames are traveling in only one direction from sender to the receiver. The sender sends a sequence of frames without even thinking about the receiver. That is, does it is reaching to the receiver or it has been lost in the medium or channel itself. To send 3 frames of data over the network, the sender have 3 events occur at the sender side and 3 events at the receiver side. This is simply about simplest protocol in flow control. Let us see next protocol, that is stop and wait protocol. The stop and wait protocol is nothing but a bidirectional communication. This is a data link layer protocol, that is in a OSI model. This protocol works in data link layer. The sender sends next packet of data if sender receives acknowledgement from the receiver for the previous data. That is, when a sender starts its transmission and sends first bit of data, when the acknowledgement is received from the receiver, then only he sends the next data. Otherwise, if the acknowledgement is lost or the data is lost in the medium or channel itself, he waits infinite time by not continuing the communication. Let us see some disadvantages of stop and wait protocol. That is, when acknowledgement is lost and when the data is lost. When the acknowledgement is lost, the sender sends the data and waits for the acknowledgement from the receiver. But the receiver sends the acknowledgement while this acknowledgement is lost in the medium. The sender waits for the acknowledgement infinite time and thinks he is sending and the acknowledgement is on the way. But the acknowledgement was already lost in the medium. So this communication would not continue. And in other case, when the data is lost, that is, the sender sends the data through the channel or medium, but it is lost as it is a noisy channel. The sender thinks that as we have already sent the data, we are waiting for the acknowledgement from the receiver. But as the receiver does not receive the data, he cannot send the acknowledgement. So in this case also, the data transmission was collapsed. Now let us see some more protocols on noiseless channels, noisy channels, that is stop and wait ARQ. First of all, let us know what is ARQ. Automatic repeat request. That means in this, the request will be automatically repeated. That is, waits for some time and sends another request. This is a main advantage in the stop and wait protocols of ARQ. In this, each data packet is sent and the sender waits certain time for the acknowledgement. If time out, then the sender sends same data until it gets acknowledged from the receiver. Simply, we can say that stop and wait ARQ is nothing but stop and wait protocol plus some timeout condition which wait for some time in for waiting the acknowledgement plus sequence of data packets for the transmission. This is simply about the stop and wait protocol. Let us see some scenarios in stop and wait ARQ. Those are when acknowledgement is lost, when acknowledgement is received after the timeout, when the data is lost. When the acknowledgement is lost is nothing but the sender sends the data and waits for the acknowledgement from the receiver for certain time. But as the acknowledgement is lost in the medium itself, the acknowledgement cannot be received by the sender. So he waits for the timeout and sends the data again. Here you can see data 1 and the data 1. Same data is being transmitted, and this time the sender receives the acknowledgement from the receiver as he get the data and send the acknowledgement perfectly before the timeout itself. And let us see when data is lost first. When data is lost, that is the sender transmits the data which has been lost in the medium. As the data is not received by the receiver, he cannot send the acknowledgement. So the sender waits for certain time and retransmits the data. That is data 1, same packet of data, and wait for the timeout. But this time the receiver received the data, so he sends the acknowledgement through the medium and which was reached by the sender in before the timeout. But we can see a condition that the data has been received by the receiver and acknowledgement was sent, but which has been received by the sender after the timeout. In this case, when the timeout is completed, he thinks that acknowledgement, the sender thinks that acknowledgement was lost in the medium. So let us retransmit the data. So he starts the retransmission and waits for the acknowledgement from the receiver. So this acknowledgement would not be considered as it is timeout when acknowledgement is received, but after the timeout. These are the different scenarios of stop and wait ARQ, that is automatic request, repeat request. Now let us see some more protocols. That is sliding window protocol. Sliding window protocol is nothing but sending a set of data through the channel to the receiver. When the receiver gets the data, he acknowledges for each bit of data that he received. But the set of data, that is how many data packets should be sent, would be find out by checking for the strength of the channel and strength of the receiver and the minimum of them. That is, the receiver can handle an approx of 5 packets, and when the channel can transmit up to 8 packets, minimum of 8 and 5 should be 5. So the sender sends 5 packets of data to the receiver through the channel. In this way, the sliding window protocol works. First, he sends the 5 packets and waits for the acknowledgement. This acknowledgement should be received by the sender before the timeout. Then he sends the next set of packets and receives the acknowledgement. This is how the sliding window protocol works. Let us see. In sender sends a set of data according to the window size. We have already discussed this. When the sender receives the acknowledgement for the send bits, then he slides the window. That is, let us think the window, or this is the set. When he receives the acknowledgement, he shifts the window from here to the here, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 packets. This is the main theme of the sliding window protocol, sliding the window from one set of data to the next set of data by receiving the acknowledgement. Let us see some parts in them. That is go back ARQ. This is very typical but very good concept with a slight problem. That is, first let us see the data. That is, if a receiver receives a damaged frame, or If an error occurs while receiving a frame, then the receiver sends a negative acknowledgement from that frame along with the frame number. That is expected to be retransmitted. That is, let us see this image first. That is, the sender is transmitting the set of data with a window size of 5 packets at a time. But the receiver has received 0, 1, 2 packets successfully. As there is a problem with the third packet, he negatively acknowledged with the packet number of 3, that he is stating that I have a problem with the packet 3, so please retransmit from the packet 3 till the window size. That is, as the window size is 5, here the set of data was transmit till 4, please transmit the bits 3 and 4 as I have already discarded them. So the sender takes it acknowledgement and reset his window size from the third packet to the window size number, that is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, as he can send 5 packets at a time. So he transmits the data, but in this case also there was a problem with the fifth packet. So he sends the data, that acknowledgement, negative acknowledgement, that I have a problem at the packet 5, stating that before packets, those are 3 and 4, were successfully received and 5, 6, 7 were discarded. So the sender would take this data and retransmit from 5, 6, 7 along with the data he left, that is 8 and 9. So when the receiver receives this data successfully, he acknowledged that I have received packet 9. That is, here this packet 9 states that I have received all the packets from the starting till the packet 9. That means it is a successful transmission. In this way, go back and ARQ works. Let us see this data for better understanding. After sending negative acknowledgement, the receiver discards all the data frames, that is, receives after a damaged frame. As we have already discarded that, when there is a negative acknowledgement, after that packets all were discarded by the receiver. The receiver does not send any acknowledgement for the discarded frames. After the sender receives the negative acknowledgement for the lost frame, it retransmits lost frame referred by negative acknowledgement and also retransmits all the frame which it has already sent after the lost frame. That is nothing but he does not acknowledge for the package that he have discarded. So the sender would understand by this negative acknowledgement that from the third packet till the window size, all the packets were discarded. So we have to retransmit these bits. This is the problem with the negative acknowledgement. As third data was problem, fourth data might be good. He can accept it, but he is rejecting this packet also. This could be corrected in the selective repeat ARQ. That is, here the sender is sending 5 packets at a time and the receiver had a problem at third packet. He negatively acknowledged it. In this, the fourth packet would also be successfully received by the receiver. So the sender would understand that there is only a problem with the negative acknowledgement at the packet 3. So I have to send the packet 3 with the next window size value, that is 5, 6, 7, 8, as I can send 5 packets at a time. 3, which has a negative acknowledgement, and remaining packets, that is after the 5, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, totally 5 packets, which could be sent through the channel. And there is a problem with the packet 6, which is discarded. But after the packet 7 and 8 were successfully transmitted, here we left only with the data 9. So he transmits the data 9 with the negatively acknowledgement packet, that is 6. 6 and 9 were transmitted and were received by the receiver successfully. So he acknowledged for the packets 9, that is, he had successfully received all the 9 packets. This is how selective repeat ARQ works. Let us see the content. If a receiver receives a damaged frame, it sends the negative acknowledgement for the frame in which error or damage is detected. The negative acknowledgement number, like in go back ARQ, also indicates the acknowledgement of the previously received frames and an error in the current frame, as we have discussed this in the go back ARQ also. If the receiver keeps receiving the new frames while waiting for the damaged frames to be replaced, that is, the main problem with this selective repeat is this is a complex process, as he was transmitting the previously data, that is, this is a set of data, right? He needs 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 in an order, but the third packet was lost. He retransmits the data packet 5. So the sender should work for the packets that has already been sended. That is, he want to search for the total data for a packet of data in the total data. So this takes some time and complexity, while the receiver should arrange this packet which has been received in the correct order to get the data in a correct manner. So this is a problem. So the receiver had a sorting problem and the sender has a searching problem. So this selective repeat ARQ is somewhat complex in the physical nature. The frames that are received after the damaged frame are not being acknowledged until the damaged frame has been replaced. That is, here that there is a problem with the third packet, but the fourth packet has already been received successfully. So this could be acknowledged when there is a problem for the next packet. That is, here it is a discarded for the packet 6, stating that there is a negative acknowledgement at the packet 6. That is, before the packet 6, all the packets were received successfully, there is a problem with the packet 6. So please transmit this bit and transmit the remaining bits also. This is the meaning for the negative acknowledgement. As we have discussed that it requires sorting because it should sort the retransmitted data in the correct order. This is how selective ARQ technique works. That's it for this video. Have a safe and secure data transmission over the internet. Like, share, subscribe to Everything You Need. Thank you.